After two successful albums, Marvin flexed his new clout within the company. He renegotiated his contract with Motown, demanding and getting his own studio and production company.
He loved that studio. That was his pride and joy.
The way he would overdub his own voice and the way he would make lyrics up as he go and the way he would take instruments. I mean, it could be a fart and he would hit it on something to give a sound.
He was a genius in front of that dead microphone. Because he could do some things that people wouldn't realize. You know, Marvin's doing all the voices.
He's doing background and a lead. And to color the background, it's 4 to 5 different harmony parts. And that's what you hear.
I think the irony about Marvin is that the different voices in his head, one whispering, love God, another whispering, get everything you can, these warring voices which tore him up, he was able to harmonize, literally harmonize in his art.
Precious, pure, and fair.